fishing. So we have seen what is fishing in the previous module, about little definition about fishing. Now we are going to learn little more in detail about the fishing. So fishing, the very first, the year it was introduced is 1996. Fishing is nothing but fake email using other reputed companies. Or individuals' identity. So fake email using other reputed companies is, for example, still if you are in a second semester, one of the mail it is coming from Microsoft. How it look like that? HR@microsoft.com. But actually that mail not sent by the Microsoft employee. It might sent by the person who is doing the phishing attack. What the message subject line is that we are interested to hire PMSIT students when they are in learning stage itself. So most of you are get attracted because Microsoft. If you get job in Microsoft, your life is going to settle. You are thinking in that direction as a normal user, then you are going to open the attachment or open the email. You are the prey of the attacker if you open up such kind of the attachments and the email. Means on behalf of someone, they are sending a message like it is come from the original source or original intent. People associated phishing with email message that spoof or mimic banks, credit card companies or other business such as Amazon and eBay. So usually the attacker, if they attack someone, they should get some gain from the victim. So most of the time, rather than attacking the normal, just collecting, gathering information, not only that attack, the people, means attacker, should get the money in terms of monetary benefit or in terms of the destruction of the credentials or trust of the organization. So if he or she do that one, he is going to be funded by somebody. Ultimately, whatever you do today, every person in this world, most of the person in this world, expect ultimate goal is making money. Okay, either hacker or the defender, or the offender, or the normal person, or the employee, or the student, whoever may be, the ultimate is the money, end up with money. So most of the time you are receiving the mails such that it comes from Amazon is offering, eBay is offering, our credit card companies offering. If you buy the credit card today as a student, if you are not 10 years of down the line, you are not required to pay the fee for the banks and all. So such kind of offers, before entering into, before the victim or prey of such kind of attack, you should be very careful. How phishing works. These are the steps involved in phishing. You can observe the steps, most of the steps, plan of the attack. Basic steps of plan of attack is reconnaissance, that is information gathering, scanning and analysis, then attack, launch attack. Then finally, if it is an attacker, clear the tracks or cover the tracks. Basic steps of attacks. So here phishing is also a one kind of attack. It also follows the life cycle of that attack. Basic steps of attack is planning again. So planning, decide the target to whom, whether you are targeting to individual or the group of company or what. Decide the target and determine how to get email address. So you may generate the fake emails using email generator. Fake email generators. There are, even for that also, there are several email generator is available. One is temp mail, disposable temporary email. So one time sending the mail and it just destroys that email. So there are so many fake email generators are available. You can make use of any of the such generators, and you can target and plan for the attack of phishing. Then you can target, you can use that email address to send a email to the victim. Then set up. Yes, once you decided who is the target, for example, Shivakumar sir is the target, determine how to get the email, how we can spoof him, decide which email ID is to be chosen. For that, what you require to understand, that you need to study the targeted person of his interest. If you study his interest, so he definitely is going to click on such kind of emails. So you need to be gather the information about a targeted victim. Then decide the corresponding email address. Okay. Then set up, create methods for delivering the message and to collect the data about the target. So what is the method? Means if you choose the email sending, choose it. So what is the method? What is his targeted in? He is very much like about the website he is going to browse. If I send an email message, or how I should attack him, either I have to provide the links or I have to provide the attachment. So if attachment, whether he or she may going to open or not. If I send as a bare open email statements with the link, there is a possibility, or hiding the information using the image, it is termed to be as a steganography. Sending image as a attacking method. So what kind of the person is targeted, collect such information. So how may, several times by clicking the image, that is going to be compromised. Targeted machine is going to be compromised. By clicking the hyperlinks, there is a possibility of compromise. by clicking the attachment, by just by downloading or just downloaded content, if you open, so there is a possibility of attack. So decide yourself how, what way you are targeting the victim and delivering the message. By sending SMS, hey Shivakumar, your credit score is very, very good. So without any processing, you are going to, account is going to credited in 1 hour, 10 lakh rupee. This is another kind, another SMS, sending SMS. Sending bit.ly links, that is short links. Hyperlinks, that is bit.ly links, bit.ly dot means short forum links. You don't know which link it is there at the behind the scene of that bit.ly. See how, which are the different ways are there to target the victims, right? So to cheat the targeted machine or targeted victim, several ways are there. Then once planning is done, set up one method of targeting, how to send the message to the target and targeted interest. If you are gather such information, then attack. Planning is over, setup is ready, now attack. So sends a phony message. Phony message is nothing but it is like a original message or some funny message also that appears to be from a reputable source. That message looks like it comes from the original sender has sent message. You are going to feel such way. So attack happens by sending a phony message that appears to be from a reputable source. Then once message is sent, collection is the fourth step. Record the information of victims entering into web pages or pop-up window. So how the victim is going to respond to your message, you need to have a collection. Once that targeted message is sent to the target machine, how the user is responding to your message. Either he is just ignoring or deleting or closing the browser or reading, or if he started reading, means definitely there is a little time he is going to spend on that. Based on the time, how long you have been staying in that web page, how long you are browsing that web page, how long you are being there in that web page, they are going to calculate. Based on that, they will come to know what they have intended is you are the target of that prey of that attack. So collection, record the information of victims entering into web pages. If you are keep on web, entering the information which is asked by them, they are going to collect all the data. Then finally, identify theft and fraud. Use information that have gathered to make illegal purchases and commit fraud. On behalf of you, they are going to buy because you have given up your all the credentials, what they are expected. Based on that, it's a one way of attacking. They may not going to get entire information of you. They are trying to get basic information like your address, your contact number, your email ID, and your name, your age or the date of birth. So this is one way. Second way, they are going to do social engineering. They are targeting you and collecting which are the interest, likes and dislikes of you. So from another mode of attack like Facebook or the WhatsApp, they are keep on trying. So if one fine day they are going to get even including your bank details also. Then after collecting all the gathered information, they will do on behalf of you. They are going to do the fraud or the purchase, illegal purchases they are going to do. Okay, so this is the phishing attack, how phishing work: planning, setup, attack, collection, identity theft, or fraud. Now, virus and worms. Virus, worms, Trojan and backdoors are the subtopics of interest we are going to discuss. So, what is the meaning of virus? What's the meaning of virus? Virus is also a program that can infect legitimate programs by modifying them to include a possibly evolved copy of itself. What it means? What is virus? It is a software program or the computer program. It replicates itself and going to be infect a particular file, and it is going to be corrupt the data. Is termed to be a virus. For example, there are many different types of viruses are there. So you can create the virus using Notepad. You can create the Trojan. You can create the steganographic viruses. You can create the virus using Python language. You can create the virus using Java language. You can create the worms using the Notepad. See, it is required the knowledge of script. It is required the knowledge of script. There are several ways to create the viruses, worms, malwares, trojans, and backdoor entries. Okay, computer virus is a what? It's a program that can infect legitimate programs. Here, legitimate programs might be your MS Word file or Excel file or the any documentary or program code itself. It is, if it is going to infect or it is going to contaminate. Contaminate means unwanted insertion of the code inside the program. It's a contamination. Modifying them to include a possibly evolved copy of itself. So most of the time, viruses usually it comes from the external device like USB. If you are using USB for insertion in different systems, unknown system, there is a chances of infecting the virus to the pen drive, and that pen drive, when you insert into your local machine or the desktop, it is going to be affected. So viruses spread themselves without the knowledge or permissions of the users. It contains malicious instructions. Viruses, when they spread themselves, when you are going to explicitly inserted the external portable devices, or if you may be downloaded some of the malicious content over the web, or if it is going to be downloaded as a copy of it, then it start acting on the legitimate files of your system and it is going to be corrupt. Once it is going to corrupt, the system behaves in different way. So a virus can start on event-driven effects. Event-driven effects is nothing but there are two types of events driven. One is three types of event driven. Depending on the device type you are using, if you are using the laptop or desktop, two types of events. If you are using a smartphone, three type of events. So two types of events is, one is keyboard events, the second one is mouse events, whereas third one is touch events. So depending on the device type, event types are different. If we consider it for the device like laptop or desktop, keyboard events. Which are the keyboard events? Key in, key release, key out, key click, etc. Whereas mouse events, left click, right click,
double click, click,
double click,
hold, right click,
scroll up, scroll down, mouse over, mouse out, mouse in. Yes, yes or no? Right. Then touch events. Which are the touch events in the smartphone you are using? Touch itself, zoom in, zoom out, taking screenshots. Right. Yes or no? Click, double click, triple click, seven times click. These are all the touch events. So a virus can start on if you click or touch or zoom in or zoom out or key in or key out, key release, key pressed, or mouse in, mouse over, mouse out. If you do any of the such activity on the virus file, virus infected file, it is going to be triggered. And time driven effects, it is termed to be as a logical bomb. Time driven effects, usually it is termed to be as a logical bomb. Logical bomb, what it will do? Usually logical bombs, they are setting the time setting. When time reaches, then it is going to be blast. Similarly, in virus case, if they set every morning at 0th hour, which is the 0th hour? Early morning, 0th hour means very midnight. It is, that file is going to be triggered. That is time driven effects, or can occur random. Either it might be a click or it may be time driven or mixed mode. Depending on how you are coding or how you are writing the script. Viruses can take some actions. Which are actions? Usually it display a message to prompt an action into which viruses enter. What it is going to display the message? Is there any message the virus is going to display? Can you tell some example? Did you face any virus in your lifetime?
Oh, sir.
Which virus?
File missing.
File missing
sometimes.
Win32.system32, some kind of message it is displaying. Some kind of driver information it is displaying. Or it is creating all the file name with the same content dot some link XLX or some LNK, such kind of extension it is going to append to the all the files. Do you remember?
Yes, sir.
So viruses scramble data on hard disk. If it enters into the local system or the desktop, what it is going to do harm, it is going to change the extensions of executable files. If it changes the extension of executable files, the operating system is going to get confusion. When it is going to get confusion, the operating system, because it is searching for the .exe or .dll file to execute and run the program and the process. Once all the extension is replaced by the virus junk, then the operating system may going to corrupt. It is nothing but it changes or scramble means destroys the data on the hard disk. Then delete files inside the system. If virus is designed in such a way that the intention is to destroy the data within the system, then such kind of virus is also there. Cause erratic screen behavior, some flickering behavior it is going to give. Some viruses, how they will show is they will start flickering your screen. Hard the PC and replicate themselves. Some viruses are there, they halt, temporarily halt your system. Until unless you reboot the system is not going to allow you to perform further work on that system. Some viruses in such a way that they are going to halt the PCs and personal PC is nothing but personal computers here. Replicate themselves, they start replicating themselves. True virus can only spread from one system to another system. The true virus, how they spread, they will spread from one system to another system only when you are connected with the internet or when you are using the external portable devices to plug and play from one system to another system. Otherwise, usually the viruses are resided in the individual systems. Okay, so this is the virus content. What about the worms? Is worms spreads itself automatically to other computers through networks by exploiting security vulnerabilities. So worm, how it is look like in the real world, how the worm are moving, insects are moving from one place to the another place within the house and house to house. How they are moving, whether they are entering in the main door? No. Those are entering through the cracked walls of an house. Yes or no? In the same way, they found the vulnerability to enter or penetrate easily without the disturbance of the person or the human. Similarly, the computer worm is also a program. It spreads itself. It is an automated program. It spreads across the networks by exploiting security vulnerabilities. What is the drawback of the worm? It keep on doubling itself means it is going to occupy the hard disk space. It is going to occupy the memory space. Then it is going to tell that your memory is full. When the memory is full, the performance of the system is going to be degraded. So you are feeling that I have to buy few more storage for the desktop. But actually what it was happened, because of worm affected to your system, it is going to be replicate itself. Then you are going to use the antivirus software to detect such kind of the programs. Okay, so now types of viruses. How many types of viruses are there? So categorized based on the intention, based on attack on various element of the system from which you are targeted in the system. Computer is nothing but not just a single machine. It is consists of CPU, it consists of RAM, ROM. Right, probably heard about these terminologies. Yes, hard disk, CD-ROM, floppy drive, floppy disk. Yes or no? Bluetooth. So, cameras, webcam, microphone, speakers. It's a consist of the collection of all these. Right. So, depending on the which device you are attacking, you are going to require to design such kind of viruses. There is one type of virus called as boot sector virus. Usually boot sector is it is used by the operating system to start your system. If you infect the boot system itself, system is not going to load the drivers to run the operating system. So then you are unable to open or switch on the system. So it infects the storage media on which OS is stored and which is used to start the computer system, where the important initial instructions are stored to initiate and start and running up the operating system. That is termed to be a boot sector. If you are infecting such boot sector using the boot sector viruses, you are required to write the script in such way that it is going to affect onto the boot sector. It spread to other systems when shared infected disks and pirated softwares are used. When it spreads this kind of virus, if you are creating the image of the OS of the one system, the same image is going to dump into the another system. Obviously, that is if the previous system is being affected by the boot sector virus, the second system which has the same image of the current system is going to be affected. In that way, this boot sector viruses are spreading. The second type of virus is program viruses, active when program file. Usually .exe, .binary files, .com files, .ovl, .drv, .dll, etc. Active when program file is executed. If you execute any of your program, for suppose if you are working on C program, when you compile that, which are the different set of files is going to be created, .bak file, then .exe file, that executable. When you execute that program, so it is going to, if that program is going to affected with the program virus, then it start replicating itself of several copies, makes copy of itself. So very good example is USB. If you have a USB, if one file is affected with one folder is affected with virus, if you create the new folder, that folder is also going to be affected. Because even though it is new folder, it is going to be affected because the other folder which has a program virus. The third type of virus is multipartite viruses. It is a hybrid of a boot sector and program virus. It's a combination of boot sector and program virus. It is termed to be as a multipartite virus. It acts like enter into boot sector, it acts like a boot sector virus. If it is an executable, it acts like a program virus. The fourth type of virus is stealth virus. Stealth virus is nothing but it defaces, it hides its availability to any of the antivirus program. It hides itself. So one type it is executing as a program. Second time when you are trying to locate that program with the name of the earlier identification, it may not. So it is like it masks itself. Antivirus software also cannot detect that such kind of virus. So after its file system and hide in the computer memory to remain in the system undetected. Even though if you try to delete also, sometimes it is going to be get back to the system. Probably you might observe this one if you are interacting with scanning with your system. If you are deleted by using any of the sophisticated antivirus software, after some time it might be going to appear again in your same system. So even though if you delete it, hide in the computer memory. So this is also stealth virus is also termed to be as a brain virus. It's the first computer virus named as brain, because according to the user behavior and user interaction with the system, it is going to change its the appearance every time. Getting my point? This is a stealth virus. Boot sector, program virus, multipartite, stealth virus, polymorphic viruses. It is again combination of most of the above. It's a combination of most of the above. It is like chameleon. So how the animal chameleon changes its color based on the territory. So if it is on the green grass, it is look like a green grass. If it is on the ground, it look like a chameleon. It is similar to that. It changes its virus signature every time, binary pattern, every time it spreads through the system. So, and also multiplies and infects a new file. Polymorphic generators are routines that can be linked with the existing viruses. So usually polymorphic generators will be there. It supports to the existing viruses already in the system, and it speeds up to spread of the virus throughout the system. So generators are not viruses. Those are not viruses, but those are the supporters for the existing virus to spread across the system. So generators are not viruses, but purpose to hide actual viruses under the cloak of polymorphism. So polymorphic behavior is going to be showcased by the polymorphic viruses. As I said, polymorphism, like a person in the home, maybe husband of someone, father of some child, if the same person moving traveling through the bus is a commuter, if the same person within the campus of the institution, he is the employee of that organization, if he is inside the classroom, he is the teacher of the some students, same person act differently according to the different situation. In the same way, the polymorphic viruses also act like that. So macro viruses, usually it infects the documents protected by victim computer. You can create these kind of viruses using in your Microsoft document itself. There is an option called as macros in the Word document. Macros is nothing but recording the session of the Word document you are desired. In that macros, you can inject in the main document, you can inject the virus script and record it as a macro. Whenever somebody wants to try to open, ask him to enable the editing. When you click enable editing, you are going to edit the content to the document. Okay, probably some of these kinds of things are the macro viruses. ActiveX and Java control. So ActiveX is also a scripting which is written using the Microsoft Visual Studio. Using the Microsoft Visual Studio, you can create a script to script and make it executable using the especially in the Microsoft platform. Whereas Java controls JavaScript and the JSP also Java Server Pages. It's a servlet pages, and if you are writing the viruses, you can make use of Java, and you can make use of ActiveX controls. You can make use of the scripting Perl, Ruby, Python, any of the scripting languages. You can build the viruses. Okay. Any doubts? Viruses and worms. Any doubts? No? Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, files gets converted to shortcuts. Most of the time when the pen drive or the hard disk is infected by the virus. Yes, very good. You observed that one. Good. Any questions are there? If anybody, you tried to crack the password in different ways apart from the John Ripper or the Hashcat. If you tried in a Hashcat, anybody of you tried in Hashcat using Hashcat? Or Rainbow Attack? Hashcat usually follows the Rainbow Attack. Rainbow is nothing but what? It is again a file which consists of most of the hashes. No, Vishnu, no. What about Darshan? Did you try? Venakaraj, did you try?
Yes, sir. I'm still working on it.
Which tool you are using currently?
Sir, that Kali Linux.
Kali Linux on top of it, which is the password cracking? Anybody tried using OPH? OPH tool in Kali Linux? Oh, Darshan, what about you? Still doing Raman? Panindra?
No, sir.
Mohit, Rupak?
Yes, sir. I'm using the John the Ripper with
John the Ripper is limited password
word list.
Suppose I think list. If you have a new list of the dictionary, probably you can try with John Ripper, but existing dictionary it is not going to crack. Any girls you tried to crack the password? Somashri, Navya, Sheetal, many are there, right? Okay, answer from 25th to 26th to 30th quiz. Answer for this quiz. Question is, which one of the following is also referred to as malicious software? A, malicious where, badware, illegalware, malware. USN 26. USN 26. Malware. Right. 27. Hackers usually use the computer virus for dash purpose. Hackers usually use the computer for dash purpose. To log, monitor each and every user stroke, to gain access to the sensitive information like user's ID and passwords, to corrupt the user's data stored in the computer system, or all of the above. USN 27. D. Why D? So understand the question. Hackers usually used the computer virus for dash purpose. The one is, the targeted is C. Actually, the answer is C, because to gain access the sensitive information like user's ID and password, you cannot monitor, log, monitor each and every user's stroke. It's a key logging. So corrupt the user's data stored in the computer system is the right answer. USN
28. Yes, sir.
How many types of virus are there? How many types of viruses are there according to today's class? One, two, ten, seven. USN 28. How many are there? Just now we discussed which are the viruses types. Boot sector virus 1, program virus 2, multipartite viruses 3, stealth viruses 4, polymorphic viruses 5, macro viruses 6, ActiveX and Java control viruses 7. Total, how many are there? 28, 7 virus, right. Then 29, USN. Which of the following is a type of independent malicious program that never required any host program? Any host program. And try to understand the question. for virus or anything, it is required to dependent. But for this kind of program, it does not require any supporting type. Which of the type that one? Trojan horse, warren, trapdoor, virus. What is Trojan horse? Trojan horse, the name itself says, it is a fancy word, Trojan horse. It means that within an horse, a virus is hidden. Virus is hidden. Means it requires a host. What is worm? Yeah, worm, it does not require a host because, you are right, Manoj. Worm, it does not require host because it is replicating itself. Not A, it's a B, correct. Worm is a correct. USN 30. This is one different this one. Which of the following known as the oldest phone hacking techniques used by hackers to make free calls? To make free calls. Phishing, it uses email service. Cracking, it uses password service. Spraining, what is that? Spraining means twist. So what is A? Mohit, right, you are right. Fine. Okay, I hope I made you understand today about some of the virus and the worms, right? So tomorrow Trojans and backdoors will cover, along with that so different password cracking mechanism and tools used for cracking we will discuss, along with keyloggers and spywares. Fine, tomorrow I am going to discuss about hacking. Now tomorrow means next class. Thank you. Answer your attendance.